This CLD Success Package video covers parsing data and using data structures. My name is Mark Ramsdale. I'll be your host. The first example is CLD number 7. This VI starts with the current time in a timestamp format. This timestamp is converted into two strings, and each string is parsed until all of the pieces from the timestamp can be broken down into individual elements. Some of the elements need to be converted. For example, the name of the day is converted into a digit for that day of the week. Similarly, the name of the month, and also the AM/PM of the timestamp. It can be very useful to create indicators on the front panel to see the progress and the format of the string as you proceed along the parsing. At the end, all the elements are combined together into one string according to the specification. The space is used between elements, and some of the elements are direct constants. The next example is CLD number 15. This application is a functional global variable. Inside, we see that the data must be read from the file. It's passed on to a shift register. Then a processing data step is used to convert this data into the format required. The file data is passed into the sub-VI, and the formatted results are passed out into a shift register. Nested loops are used to extract each row and column of the data for operation. The first step of the data parsing is to take elements from the string using the string subset VI. Once this data has been extracted, it can be converted according to the requirements from the specification. In this case, we're coming up with a total quantity. We're putting that value into the type def and into the shift register. The next step requires another sub-VI because it is a more complex operation on a larger string of data, the second column in the file. The contents of the shift register and the file data is passed into the subroutine. Inside we see the use of the match pattern sub-VI. It is important to understand how to create the regular expression. The LabVIEW help is a great resource for this. You may not be able to memorize all of the ins and outs, but you should be able to go to this help page and to quickly create a regular expression to meet your needs. So we see here the data string is parsed and passed along. Each step, a piece of the data is removed based on the regular expression. Again, it is convenient to have a copy of the data format so you can see what you're up against in terms of the format of the string and which pieces of data you'd like to extract. In this instance, the specification requires that some of this data be converted. Here we have the logic based on the model to perform this action. The results are stored inside the cluster and passed back out to the shift register in the calling VI. All of the parsing and formatting is completed inside the sub-VI, sub-VI being called in this case for the functional global variable. And the data is available at this point for the outside caller. In order to write the data to the file, a new file name is used, and due to planning, the parsing of the data in order to properly order it for writing to the file is as simple as opening the cluster, creating a little bit of change from data types, numeric data types, into strings, proper organization, and then passing them into the right file. For our final example, let's look at CLD exercises 10 and 11. Exercise 10 is a functional global variable. In the read mode, the data is pulled from the file. Eventually, it is put into the cluster. In this case, we have a relatively simple transformation from one data type to another. As we've seen, sometimes calculations are required, or additional analysis and conversion might be required. It is often convenient to put these conversions right in with the file I/O access. However, sometimes, as we have seen, it is convenient to have a separate sub-VI to transform the data that has been loaded from a file, or to transform data in order to write to a file. In exercise 11, we see that the file I/O is separate from the data management. The data is loaded up in this sub-VI, passed on in a shift register, and during each loop of the consumer, the data is unbundled and pushed to indicators or to another data line that ultimately goes to a shift register also. Let's take a look at this. We see here that the data is opened as it is in an array. It can be indexed. Data can be looked at from two different elements. In this particular solution, we look at the current element and the next element. We have reviewed parsing data and using data structures within the CLD exam exercises. This is a link between the file I/O and the application itself. It is important to understand what format you would like the data to be in order to be useful in the main VI and in the application. Sub-VIs are helpful. Sometimes these conversions can be made directly in the file access sub-VIs themselves. You should become familiar with the matching pattern, match expression, string subset VIs. There are some other VIs that are helpful also. In addition, be sure to know how to look up and use the LabVIEW help in order to create regular expressions.